myself Dr. W.P. Gundane from Kumaranadi Mahavidyalaya Nagpur. Today I am going to discuss the inter-halogen compounds. And halogens combine with each other to form the compound which is known as inter-halogen compound. And inter-halogen compound are represented by the formula AXN. A is the halogen with higher atomic number and X is the halogen with smaller atomic number, and N can have the value 1, 3, 5, 7, etc. And so there are different types of inter-halogen compound of the different types: AX type, AX3, AX5, AX7 types. So the topic is inter-halogen compound, and we are going to see details about the inter-halogen compound. And in this inter-halogen compound, we are going to see the different topics, that is the here preparation of inter-halogen compound, after that chemical properties of this compound, structure of the AX type, AX3 type, AX5 type and AX7 types. So what do you mean by inter-halogen compound? Here are the different types of inter-halogen compound. So first of all, the compound, we should have to know that compound formed by the halogens among themselves are also known as the inter-halogen compound. Means one halogen can combine with other halogen or with each other, forming the new type of compound are known as the inter-halogen compound. And these inter-halogen compounds are formed because of their difference in their electronegativity of the forming compound. And generally it is represented by the formula AXN type. For example, here AXN, N may be 1, 3, 5, 7. So here these inter-halogen compounds are this AX type, AX3 type, AX5 type and AX7 type. And here A is a halogen of higher atomic number and X is a halogen of smaller atomic number. For example, here AX type, ClF. Cl have atomic number 17, fluorine have a 9. So the halogen with bigger atomic number is what to write first. So this is the general formula, and example of this type is ClF, BrF, BrCl, ICl, etc. Second type is AX3 type. In this case, A is a Cl here and F3. So other examples are BrF3, bromine trifluoride, ICl3, IF3. Third type is AX5 type, and examples are IF5, BrF5, ClF5. And AX7 type having the example, well-known example, that is IF7. These are the different types of inter-halogen compound. So after this, we are going to see the preparation of these inter-halogen compound. Now there are three methods of the preparation of inter-halogen compound. And in the first method is the formation of inter-halogen compound by direct combination of halogens. So two halogens we have to combine at particular under suitable condition, then we get the inter-halogen compound. So inter-halogen compound can be prepared by direct combination of halogen atom under suitable condition. For examples are given here that chlorine and fluorine at temperature 250 degrees Celsius, they combine and forming the twice ClF. So this is the AX type of inter-halogen compound. I2 and Cl2 forming ICl type. So I2 plus 3F2 liquid, this is in an excess, then we get 2ICl3. So this is the first method in which the inter-halogen compounds are formed by direct combination of halogen. Second method is also there, and that method is the formation of inter-halogen compound from lower inter-halogen compound. By using lower inter-halogen, it is possible to form higher inter-halogen compound. So the lower inter-halogens may be changed into higher inter-halogen compound by the interaction with halogen. So here lower inter-halogen compound, now here ClF lower, and then halogen can react with this and forming ClF3. So in second case ClF3 is there, then again react with the fluorine halogen at temperature 350 degrees Celsius forming ClF5. In the likewise, IF5 combined with F2 forming IF7. So this is another method of preparation of inter-halogen compound by using lower inter-halogen and react with the halogens. And there is also another method, third method is from halides. And by using this method, inter-halogen compound can also be prepared from the some metal halide. So here we have to use the metal halide like lead iodide, potassium chloride. So PbI2 react with the fluorine forming PbF2 and twice IF7. IF7 is the internal compound. So all KCl react with the fluorine, 3 molecules of fluorine at temperature 200 degrees Celsius. We get KF and ClF5 is the compound. So likewise other compound can be prepared. So there are 3 methods of preparation of interhalogen compound. First is by direct combination, and second is from lower interhalogen, and third is from halides. And after this, now we are going to see the some properties, that is chemical properties of interhalogen compounds. And in case of interhalogen compound, they have different color. As we know that interhalogen compounds of fluorine are colorless. However, those made up of heavier halogens are colored. So color become darker as the molecular weight of the compound increases. And also melting and boiling point of this compound increases as the difference in electron negativity increases between the two halogen atoms. But now here some important chemical properties that we are going to see. First is the hydrolysis, and in case of first reaction of hydrolysis, these compounds more or less easily hydrolyze to form the halogen acid and oxyhalogen acid. And oxyhalogen acid is formed by larger halogen atom. So here see now BrCl3H2O, and oxy acids are formed by higher halogen, means BrEgR. Out of these two halogen, so they are forming oxyhalogen compound, and here oxyhalogen acids. So compound form is a halogen acid and oxyhalogen acid. So this is halogen acid, oxyhalogen acid, because oxygen is here. And so in this way, so ICl3 also react with the undergo hydrolysis and forming 3HCl and HiO2. And so similarly, IF5 also react with undergo hydrolysis. So first here, reaction shows the hydrolysis of interhalogen compound. And second reaction is that it shows the reactivity. Halogen fluoride are extremely reactive because fluorine is there. The order of reactivity of these interhalogen compounds are shown here. That is ClF3 is greater, having greater reactivity than BrF5, then it is having greater than IF5. So this is the order of reactivity of interhalogen compound. It is generally also observed that the reactivity of AX type compound has been generally found that more than as compared to the A2 or X2 molecule, means halogens. And next property is the addition reaction. And in the reaction shown, addition in double bond can take place, and interhalogen compounds of the type AX give addition reaction with the olefin. So here this is the ethylene, and BrCl is the internal compound, can be added two other BrCl AX type, and Br comes here and Cl comes here. So here addition can take place, and can whenever there is a olefin or double bond, in the double bond there is a addition, so one bond get removed and addition take place. So here we get this type of addition compound. And after this, now next slide shows others. Fourth reaction is that self-ionization. As we know that self-ionization, ICl or bromine trifluoride, these compounds undergo self or auto-ionization and forming these positive and negative ions. ICl and ICl undergo self-ionization forming I plus and ICl2 minus. BrF3 they form BrF2 plus and BrF4 minus, similar to ammonia. Ammonia also undergoes a similar reaction of self-ionization forming NH4 plus and NH2 minus. Water also undergo in self-ionization also H2O plus H2O forming H3O plus and OH minus, like that. So here this interhalogen compound also undergo self-ionization reaction. Number 5 is a reaction with alkali metal halides. So here this interhalogen compound react with the alkali metal halides, so potassium chloride, and forming this type of compound which is known as polyhalides. So ICl polyhalides which contain more than 2 or 3 halogens, so such compound is known as a polyhalides. So when alkali metal halide react with the interhalogen compound, forming the polyhalides. And last, number 6, halogenation reaction. Most of the interhalogen compound can be used as a good halogenating agent. And here IF5 used as a halogenation reagent and react with the sulfur forming SF4 and IF. So these are the 6 chemical properties of this interhalogen compound. And after this, now important part in interhalogen compound is the structure of different types of interhalogen compound. and different types of interhydrogen compounds are AX type, AX3, AX5 and AX7. So first type is a AX type of compound, and here example of AX type is a IC, here is a CLEF. What is here? CLEF. So this is the example of CLEF. First example, CLF is the example of AX type of interhalogen compound. In case of CLF, central atom is chlorine and chlorine have atom number 70 and electronic configurations is there, that is 7 electrons are there in a valence shell, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. So 7 electrons are there, 3s2, 3p5. So in the ground state of Cl, there is a 1 unpaired electron and which indicate the formation of 1 covalent bond. And actually surrounding atoms are also one. Fluorine is surrounded to this, only one surrounding atom, that is fluorine is there, and one fluorine means again we require only one unpaired electron in the ground state of Cl. Otherwise they have one single electron, and therefore there is no need of excited state. And here one s orbital, 3p orbital undergoes hybridization and forming 4sp3 hybrid orbital. So now here out of sp3 4 orbital, 1, 2, 3 orbitals are already paired, these 3 are the lone pairs, and only half filled orbital overlap with the orbital of 2p orbital of fluorine and forming one bond pair, that is forming the one covalent bond. So here, and because of the sp3 hybridization, the molecule CLF have tetrahedral shape shown here. This is the tetrahedral shape, 1, 2, 3, 4 corners are there, but because of the presence of 3 lone pair of electron, the shape of this molecule can also be considered as a linear shape, because these are the lone pairs on the Cl and only CLF bond is there, only one bond, and therefore the shape is a linear shape. So first example is a CLF of the AX type of interhalogen compound, and here example is CLF. CLF have the shape linear or having, because of hybridization in sp3, shape is a tetrahedral. Second example is CLF3, that is AX3 type of compound. Now again, now here Cl is a central atom having 7 electron in the ground state. So here again 3s2, 3p5. And in ground state there is only a single electron which indicates the formation of single covalent bond, but here surrounding atoms are 3, 3 fluorines are there, it means that we require 3 unpaired electrons. So therefore one electron is promoted from this orbital to the 3d orbital. In the excited state these 2 electrons are, it is, this pair is also as it is, only one electron from this is promoted to this 3d orbital. Now in the excited state there are 3 unpaired electrons, and these 3 unpaired electrons indicate the formation of 3 covalent bond, and therefore here 1s, 3p and 1d orbital undergo hybridization and forming 5sp3d hybrid orbital of equivalent energy and shape. And only the 3, 1, 2, 3, these 3 unpaired electrons overlap with the 2p orbital of fluorine and forming 3 covalent bond. So in this molecule there are two lone pair and 3 other bond pairs which are shown here in the diagram, and here hybridization is sp3d. Due to the sp3d hybridization, shape of this molecule is trigonal bipyramidal. In case of trigonal bipyramidal, there are 2 positions which are axial and 3 positions are there which are known as equatorial position, and there are 2 lone pair of electron. In this case these 2 lone pair of electron are occupying equatorial position, and because of that, and this shape is a trigonal bipyramidal. But now the shape of this molecule can also be considered as a T shape. This is one line and this is T shape with a bond angle 87 degree, here also 87 degree, 40 minutes, and so shape of this molecule is a trigonal bipyramidal or also considered as T shape. So this is the formation of CLF3, and 2 positions are there, equatorial position and axial position. So 2 lone pair, when they are positioned at equatorial position, then in that stage there is a minimum repulsion, and therefore this is the, they give the maximum stability to the compound. We can also place the lone pair on the axial position, but the repulsion is more between the electron pair, therefore this is the stable state, and therefore the shape is considered T shape. So CLF3 molecule have T shape structure. And third type of the compound is IF5, and this is the example of AX5 type of interhydrogen compound. And IF5 have central atom in this molecule. Central atom is iodine. Iodine had atom number 53, and valence shell configuration is shown here, 5s2, 5p5. All other halogens have 7 electrons, and here is a single electron unpaired, which is unpaired in the down state, which indicates the formation of one covalent bond. And therefore, here, after this now, and here surrounding atoms are 5, therefore we require 5 unpaired electrons, and it is possible by the promotion of 2 electrons, these 2 electrons to the 5d orbital. Now in the ground state there are 5 unpaired electrons, which indicate the formation of 5 covalent bond. And now here 1s, 3p and 2d orbital undergo hybridization and forming 6sp3b2 hybrid orbital of equivalent energy and shape. And after this now, again in this case, this 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 unpaired electron of iodine overlap with the 2p orbital of 5 fluorine atoms and forming 5 bond pair, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the electron of fluorine, this is electron of fluorine, 5 electron of iodine and 5 electrons of fluorine forming 5 covalent bond. And again now in this case, there is a 1 lone pair of electron because this orbital is already having 2 electrons. So the because of the sp3d2 hybridization, shape of this molecule is octahedral, and here the octahedral shape is shown in the figure. 5 corners are there, and here in the axial position 1 lone pair is occupying the position, and therefore because of the presence of 1 lone pair, the shape of this molecule can also be considered as a square pyramidal. This is the square and this is the pyramid because one is a lone pair. So IF5 have octahedral shape or having square pyramidal shape. And last example, IF7, this is the example of AX7 type of interhalogen compound. Again in this case of IF7, central atom is iodine and surrounding atoms are fluorine. 7 atoms are there fluorine, and again in the ground state have the 7 electron of iodine. In iodine ground state, 5s2, 5p5, again there is a single unpaired electron, and but we require 7 unpaired electron. So it is possible by the promotion of 3 electron from this filled orbital and to the 5d orbital. Now in the excited state there are 7 unpaired electron, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, 7 unpaired electrons are there, and these 7 unpaired electron here, 5s, 5p, 3 5p and 3 5d orbital undergo hybridization and forming sp3d3 hybrid orbital of equivalent energy and shape. These 7 electron of iodine overlap with the 2p orbital of 7 electrons of fluorine and forming 7 bond pair of electrons. So here is the formation of 7 fluorine from the covalent bond. And there, because of the sp3d3 hybridization, the shape of IF7 molecule is pentagonal bipyramidal. So in this case, this is the pentagon ring. Out of 7 orbital, 5 orbitals are forming a pentagon ring, and 2 are perpendicular to this plane pentagon above and below it. So those are forming the pentagon ring here, pentagon. So they have the bond angle of 72 degrees, and the orbital which are perpendicular to the plane pentagon having bond angle of 90 degrees. So in this way the IF7 molecule is formed, and this is the last example. So there are 4 types of example of interhalogen compound. One is a AX type, AX2 type, AX3 type and AX7 type. So this is the IF7 formation of this molecule. And lastly, we can also say that these interhalogen compounds have number of applications, and these applications means the compounds are very widely used in the different purpose. So first, ICL compound is used to estimate the iodine number. ICL is also used to iodinate the organic compounds. BR3, we know that bromine trifluoride is used as a solvent in the laboratory, as a non-aqueous solvent. And some of the compound of interhalogen like ClF3, BrF3, ICl3 have also been used for the preparation of polyhalides. So certain number of applications are also there of these interhalogen compounds. So these compounds are very useful. So today we stop here, and in today's discussion we have discussed the what is interhalogen compound, what are the types of interhalogen compound, and after that the preparations of interhalogen compound, and then chemical properties of interhalogen compound. And we have seen the structure of four types of interhalogen compound, that is the AX type, AX3, AX5 and AX7 types of compound. And these compound also have number of applications, can be used for the synthesis of polyhalides, they can be used as a solvent, they can be used for iodinating agents. So different types of applications are also there, so these compounds are very useful.